Hey guys, welcome back to my channel! Today I brought you another Devlog video, but before that let me say thanks for the support that I got from you about my firework game. We've reached the 20 likes in a day, so the tutorial is on the way! An important aspect or feature of RPGs are the inventory and the equipment system. There are tons of games out there that provide very clever methods and unique items. Let me show you the case with Ork Slayer. Before that, let's jump back a little to my Ascii game. There were three main shopkeeps: weaponsmiths, armorsmiths, and the alchemist. I did not really emphasize potions in my games, I usually go for two or three different health potions and a mana potion. Now take a look at the weapons and armors. Since there were three classes, warrior, hunter, and mage, I gave them their own individual equipment. They had two weapons and three armor pieces. Back then, I used colors to represent the so-called tiers of the items, and this might be familiar for most of you. White is common, green is uncommon, blue is rare, purple is epic, and yellow is legendary. Then around 1 year ago, I wanted to spice things up with Ork Slayer. I've kept the tier system, every type of item has 5 different levels, starting with tier 1. Okay, it's cool, basic progression, but I don't really like such linear things, so I introduced the new rarity system, which I refer as Enchantments 2. There are 4 rarity levels apart from the basic common equipment. Again, green is uncommon, blue is rare, purple is epic, and yellow is legendary. But what's the catch? Well, since you won't find random equipment in the wild yet, only the scripted ones, let's look at the wares. Both with weaponsmiths and armorsmiths, and also the jeweler, but I haven't showed him yet, you can notice that every time the item in the middle has no glowing particles. The reason behind this is that there's an exact recipe for what kind of items they bring for you. Let it be a weapon, a headpiece, a chestplate, etc. The recipe is the following. For every type of item, you'll see three options. The game takes into account the tier of your current equipment. The first item is from the same tier, but an enchanted one. The next one is the basic item from the plus one tier. And the last one is from the next tier as well, but enchanted. So if your equipment is tier 1, then you'll find an enchanted tier 1, a basic tier 2, and an enchanted tier 2 at the shop. Every item has its own price, and the rarity level puts a multiplier on that. Now let's move ahead to the enchantments. While the basic equipment parts boost your attribute points like strength, the enchantments give bonuses to secondary stats such as mana points. For every equipment and every class, these bonuses are different, and the higher the rarity, the more bonuses there are to get from. Here's a quick example with the current state of the game for the warrior. An uncommon weapon can only yield plus 2 damage. A rare weapon can give plus 4 damage or 3 critical chance. An epic weapon can give plus 7 damage, 5 critical chance or 10 mana points, while a legendary weapon can have plus 12 damage, 8 critical chance, 15 mana points or 10 wisdom. So the pool of stats are increasing with the rarity. One last thing is the art. I think I found a clever method of displaying different items. As you can see, there are always three items shown by the merchant, and the selected one has outline corresponding to its rarity level. This can be achieved by loading a sprite sheet with the outlined variants and loading the right one if it's selected. If not, the one without outline. Lastly, the effect I'm really proud of can be seen below. On the left, there's your equipment, and on the right, there's the selected one. A nice shine is played periodically with a simple animation, and the glowing particles are displayed randomly. This can be achieved by loading the sprite sheet, slicing it to different sprites, then displaying all of them while changing the different transparencies. That's about the functionality of the equipment in my game. There's a lot to cover in the future, and a lot of items to grind for, since there will be 4 heroes and they will have unique stuff. 1 weapon and 3 armor pieces for every tier and every hero. With 4 heroes and 5 tiers and 4 equipment types, this means 4 times 5 times 4, which is 80 items.
Bruh.
Jeez, that's a lot of drawing. Wish me luck and encourage me on this hard journey, I count on your support. That was it for today's video, let me know how you liked it, and remember, the tutorial for my firework game is in progress. Thanks a lot for watching, leave a like and subscribe so you won't miss any new content. Until next time, stay safe and take care. We'll be right back.